As the name suggests, these effects modify the shape of the waveform passing through them. The distortion and cabinet simulator devices focus on making changes to the signal vertically, while the LofiMat applies restrictions to both the vertical and horizontal planes. All three feature separate dry and wet mix sliders for complete control over the volume of the original and altered audio. The distortion effect has four modes that warp a waveform's amplitude in a variety of ways. Drive sets the strength of the distortion, while tone controls a pre-filter to increase or reduce how bright the distortion is. Razor is the traditional method of ramping up the volume to cause clipping, creating the regular harsh overdrive style of distortion. Shape mode is similar, but instead of simply being clamped at the artificial max volume level, the new waveform is allowed to be saturated around that point. This difference is obvious both when listening to the output and when looking at these rendered waveforms. True to its name, fold mode partly folds the signal back towards the DC line, generating a slightly triangular shape. At higher values, this really mangles the sound, making a distinctive growl. Going beyond this, though, just creates noise. Shift is similar, but actually folds the waveform back over to the other side of the DC line. This gives it a very scratchy character, without ever turning to complete noise. The 8x button enables 8 times oversampling, and this will help to reduce any aliasing introduced by the distortion process, but it does require more CPU power. The lo-fi mat effect degrades the quality of the input audio by reducing the bit depth and sample rate. In case you're unfamiliar with these terms, let's take a look at what they mean on a sample. Bit depth refers to the amount of vertical steps there are to represent different volume levels. Renoise processes everything internally at a highly accurate bit depth of 32 bits, but the bit crunch slider reduces the amount of these vertical steps so that the audio becomes less accurate at representing differences in volume. Go low enough and certain parts of the waveform become silent because they're forced to play on the DC line. The sample rate is the amount of times per second that a separate point of volume will be represented. This is normally controlled by whatever you've set the application to use, but the rate slider reduces the amount of these horizontal points so that the audio becomes less accurate at representing changes taking place across time. Go low enough, and any rhythm that existed becomes very indistinct. The noise slider adds extra noise into the signal, which will also be degraded by the effect. Enabling the smooth button does exactly what you'd expect. It's less accurate to the settings, but the sound generated may be more to your liking. Gentle use of this device can be good for generating new harmonics, while heavier settings function as a bit crusher to emulate older digital hardware. The cabinet simulator recreates the sound of hardware amplification cabinets. While obviously aimed at affecting guitar and bass instruments, it's also great for adding some analog-style roughness to anything you'd like. The effect consists of three components. A tube preamp controlled by the gain slider to create distortion. An equalizer at the right, see the equalization video for more details. And the cabinet itself, which can be any of 18 different models. While this is fantastic as it is, what makes this device truly special is the routing option. Here, you can arrange the three components into any configuration you'd like, which can vastly change the sound produced. You can also change the processing to mono, so that the incoming stereo signal will be combined into a single channel. This makes the cabinet simulator twice as efficient. So if the input signal is mono, or you just prefer it this way, then this can be useful to save on CPU power.